Hi, this is HJ. In this video, I will introduce how to animate visual elements in the UI toolkit using the Unity timeline. As I pointed out in the previous videos, animation in the UI toolkit still has many limitations. USS transition animations or direct scripting can be efficient and effective for simple interactions and transitions. However, in games, there are times when more complex and exaggerated animations are required. Some may point out performance issues with UGUI. Nonetheless, there are many alternatives. On the contrary, the UI toolkit lacks alternatives. On the Unity website, there is a page called Unity Platform Roadmap. You can see the development plans for UI systems, that is UI toolkit. Supporting keyframed animation is on the planned list. It seems positive that they are aware of the problem and have a plan to support it. However, it is still unknown when it will be implemented and raised to a level that can be used in practice. Then I came across an interesting post on the Unity forum a couple of months ago. It said you can animate visual elements using Unity timeline. It was exactly what I had been waiting for. I tried it without hesitation. The workflow was intuitive and the level of integration with the timeline was quite high, so I made a Korean tutorial back then. I think it would be nicer to share this great project with more people. First, you should install this project. If you are familiar with the installation from GitHub, this part can be skipped. The URL is in the description. Go to the project page, click the green button labeled code, and then copy the repository address. Back to your Unity project, open the package manager. There's a plus button at the top left. Select Add Package from Git URL and paste the address you copied. Press the Add button to install the package. Once the installation is over, let's get started. In this video, I'll animate some parts of this UI. There are four curved planes behind the character. When the scene starts, they slide into the screen one by one. In order to animate those visual elements, we need a simple setting first. Select the game object to which the UI document component is attached. Create a child game object and add a playable director component. This component will read animations from the timeline. Create a playable asset which will store animation data made in the timeline. Put it in the playable field. Double-click the playable asset in the project window to open the timeline. Some of you may already be good at the timeline, but I will explain it based on those who are new to the timeline. To animate something in the timeline, a track is needed. If you right-click on the empty space, the menu will come up. Most of them are the timeline's default tracks. At the bottom, however, there is an item called UIT Timeline. If your menu doesn't have it, you should check the plugin is properly installed. Select the UIT Visual Element track. A new track for visual elements is created. Now let's specify which visual element to animate. It's the USS selectors that are used for specifying in this plugin. On the GitHub page, supported selectors are listed. You can see name selector, class selector, and so on. Their usages are almost identical to those in the UI toolkit. We will use the name selector, which adds sharp ahead of a visual element's name. I mentioned that four planes would slide into the screen. Check the name in the UI builder, and then change the track's name with the name selector. Now that the visual element to animate is picked, we tell the timeline which property to animate. This plugin supports following animations. Transform properties such as position, rotation, size, and opacity. In addition to this, display, visibility, and class can be turned on and off. Since the plane is to be moved, add a position clip. Select the clip and go to the inspector. When the scene is played, the plane has to be off screen. Make sure that the playhead is at frame 0. Enter -2000 in the X field. And then add a key. If the key is successfully added, a small graph editor will appear below the clip. You can add or modify keys here. Move the playhead to the end of the clip. enter 0 in the X and add a key so that the plane will slide into the original position. Double-click the clip to open the animation window. Although the small editor is available, I prefer editing keys here. One of the great things about this plugin is that you can preview the animation without having to play the scene. Just click the play button or move the playhead in the timeline or animation window. The Unity Timeline is a non-linear animation editor. This plugin takes advantage of the characteristic. If you make a clip shorter, it reduces the animation duration and speeds it up accordingly. Or you can set its speed multiplier and duration and then manually reposition the keys. Furthermore, the Dope Sheet and Curve Editor are also available for each clip. Let's examine the animation editing feature a little more. Add a rotation clip immediately after the position clip. Set a proper duration and have it rotate 360 degrees. When previewed, it plays as expected. Pull the rotation clip a bit forward so it overlaps with the position clip. Play the animation. Two animations are blended in the overlapping section. Delete the rotation clip added for the test. Using animation layering, I'll make the plane fade in as it enters into the screen. Right-click the track and add a layer. With layers, you can animate other properties on the same target. Add an opacity clip on the new layer. Match its start time and duration to the position clip. At start, it's invisible. Go to zero frame and set the opacity to -1. Add a key. Go to 30 frame, add a key with 0. The plane will become fully visible before the movement ends. There are 4 more planes like this one. They can share the same position and opacity animation. What they differ is the start time. They should come in one by one with a slight time interval. With the non-linearity of the timeline, it can be handled readily. Select the track and duplicate it 4 times. Change the track's names to match the visual elements' names. Don't forget to prepend the sharp. Preview the animation. The duplicated tracks don't play animations. It happens sometimes, especially when you make a new track and rename it. If so, run the scene briefly. All the animations play well. Push back the start of each track a little so that they start one by one. Everything looks fine at first glance, but when you look at closely, animations pop at the both ends of the clip. This is because the gap on the track is considered to have no key by default. We have to set how to interpolate the gap and the both ends of the clip. It's called gap extrapolation. You can find the animation extrapolation section in the inspector. Select all the clips. I'll add 1 second delay for the whole animation. What we want is to match the value in the gap with the clip's start and end values and hold them permanently. Set the mode to hold both in the pre and post extrapolate. Let's preview the animation. The popping issue has been well taken care of. When the last clip ends, the whole animation restarts immediately. It can prevent you from seeing the whole animation properly. The total playback time of this playable asset is set to the end of the last clip by default. Select the playable asset in the project window. The duration mode is currently set to based on clip. Change it to fixed length and enter 5 seconds in duration. The whole animation will last for 5 seconds. We've previewed the animation many times so far, but I don't think the scene has been actually played ever. Let's see if it actually works. The scene doesn't play with these errors. In the playable director component, you can see the play on awake is turned on by default. This property will have the animation play automatically when the scene starts. The GitHub page tells what's going on. When the component played the animation, the UI document was not initialized yet. It's why the error occurred. The plugin offers a solution. Turn off the Play on Awake in the playable director. Add the delayed Play on Awake component, which is included in the plugin. Play the scene again. You can see the animation plays as in the preview. As mentioned before, this plugin supports two kinds of animations. In the second kind of animations, you can change a state of certain properties. With display or visibility clips, visual elements can be shown or hidden at certain time. It's not that difficult to imagine how these clips work, but a class clip may be hard to imagine at first. In the UI toolkit, adding or removing a style class can trigger transition animation. I prepared a simple transition animation. It can be previewed in the UI builder by add or removing the selector. Previously, this adding and removing were done by script. Using this plugin, you do the same visually in the timeline. Create a track group to organize the existing tracks. Create a new visual element track. As before, I use a name selector to specify the visual element to be animated. Add a class clip to the track. With the clip selected, go to the inspector and write the name of the style class to be controlled. The style clip represents the time the style is in the style list. When the clip starts, the style is added. When the clip ends, it's removed. Let's see if the animation plays as intended. The transition is well triggered at the both start and end of the clip. Lastly, I will briefly introduce another feature related to optimization. If you look at the UI builder, there is something called usage hint in the attribute. Its role is to tell the Unity how the visual element is used. For example, if a visual element is frequently transformed, you set it to dynamic transform. Then the vertices of the elements are processed by GPU. Otherwise, CPU takes care of the transformation when necessary. Select a track in the timeline. You can see the automatic usage hint is checked. It automatically sets the visual element's usage hint according to the clip. However, several other factors must be taken into account when making this setting. It's up to you whether you would entirely rely on this feature. In this video, we looked at how to animate visual elements using Unity Timeline. The UI toolkit's animation capabilities are currently lacking in many ways. In this situation, this project is useful in itself and will influence the future development of the UI toolkit. I want to say thank you to the developer. If you visit my channel, you can see other interesting Unity-related works, especially UGUI animation and effects. Thank you for watching.